The incoming and outgoing secretaries of the Department of Social Welfare and Development have started holding talks for the transition process. Let's get more details regarding this from DSWD spokesperson Irene Dumlao. Good afternoon, ma'am. Thank you for joining us.
Yeah, good afternoon, Ms. Denise. Thank you for having us.
Now, how has those talks been so far? It's the first of many more to come as we welcome the new administration. So as we start off, how has it been?
Well, foremost, I'd like to mention that the DSWD, in our aim to ensure smooth and well-coordinated transition, we organized a transition team, headed, of course, by our Undersecretary for Social Welfare, that's Undersecretary Danilo Paponag. And one of the activities that we initiated was the transition meeting between the transition team of the DSWD and of the incoming Secretary Erwin Dulfo. So yesterday, we had a meeting wherein the DSWD transition team briefed the team of incoming Secretary Dulfo on the DSWD's mandate, the landscape, our organizational structure, the major programs and services, our major accomplishments, the key milestones of the department during the time of Secretary Bautista, and as well as the propositions for the incoming secretary. Apart from this briefing, we discussed yesterday the succeeding meetings that we will be having with his team, or with the team of Secretary Dulfo, wherein our clusters in the central office and the field offices, to include the attached and supervised agencies of the department, will have separate meetings starting tomorrow to discuss the functions of those offices, the key result areas, as well as the recommendations or the propositions of the current administration for the incoming secretary.
So just to clarify, ma'am, it was the DSW team that were the ones who reached out to the team of Senator-elect Dulfo.
Well, yeah, that's part of our activities to ensure a seamless transition, a well-coordinated transition. So we coordinated with his team and we agreed on having this, on having that meeting yesterday.
And any news on when the incoming and outgoing secretaries will be meeting personally to talk about this?
Well, yesterday, Secretary Rolly Bautista and incoming Secretary Dulfo had an opportunity to meet and discuss some matters that pertains to the transition that will be happening. And as I've earlier mentioned, there will be a series of meetings or briefings that will be done by our clusters and field offices in preparation for the actual turnover of responsibilities to the incoming administration by the end of June.
How about Secretary Bautista himself? Will he be meeting incoming Secretary Dulfo personally about this?
Yes. In fact, yesterday they had a separate time. Okay. Also, Secretary Rolly Bautista took incoming Secretary Erwin Dulfo to his office, and they had some private time and talked about certain matters pertaining to the operations of the department.
And I know a handbook was given to incoming Secretary Dulfo about the landscape overview of DSWD throughout the 6 years, but do you mind letting us know also about, you know, the past 6 years, just a look back on how the progresses, also the accomplishments, and maybe points of improvement that the DSWD has experienced now?
Well, that's correct. The DSWD prepared a transition handbook that contains a comprehensive overview of the department and relevant information on the major functions, the services and programs that will help the incoming administration to have a better view of the roles and functions of the agency. With respect to the accomplishments of the department for the past 6 years, it's contained in the handbook. We would like also to mention that the programs and initiatives that the outgoing management hopes to be sustained by the incoming management includes the release of the updated National Household Targeting System for Poverty Reduction, or the Listahan entry. Likewise, the implementation of the Pantawid Pamilyang Pilipino program, which is the flagship program on poverty reduction, and in line with our commitments under the PSWD Strategy 2028, we hope that this will be expanded to cover more new poor in our program.
And likewise, and, oh, sorry, continue.
Yes. Aside from that, as we look back on the accomplishments of the DSWD for the past 6 years, we also included in our handbook the accomplishments under the CAPIT-BSIG Laban sa Kahirapan Comprehensive and Integrated Delivery of Social Services, wherein from 2018, the Kalahisids delivered more than 11,000 community sub-projects that has also empowered more than 3 million households in our target benefit municipalities or communities. Likewise, our accomplishments under the Sustainable Livelihood Program, wherein since 2016, we provided more than 20 billion pesos to more than 1.7 million beneficiaries in need of livelihood assistance. And during the pandemic, when many people lost their sources of income, the Sustainable Livelihood Program was one of the life buoys of more than 260,000 of our fellow Filipinos who were given livelihood assistance grants as provided under our existing guidelines. Under our disaster response and management, we also enumerated or provided the accomplishments wherein we mentioned that since 2018, more than 797,000 households were served with emergency shelter assistance, while more than 633 households also benefited from cash for works. This is on top of the assistance that we provided also under our cash for work program in support of our climate change adaptation and mitigation activities. Again, that's on top of the family food packs and non-food items that we provide during disaster response operations of the department. And also, we included under our accomplishments the construction, rehabilitation, and improvement of our centers and residential care facilities, wherein we mentioned that more than 71, or at least 71 of our CRCFs were renovated or refurbished. And because of that, the department is able to provide shelter for the protection and rehabilitation of our clients. At the same time, under the registration, licensing, and accreditation of social welfare and development agencies, we were able to effectively and efficiently facilitate this the service delivery for our clients. So these are just some of the accomplishments that we enumerated and were included in the transition handbook that we crafted for the incoming leadership.
You know, lots of progress for the incoming administration to build on. But how about the points of improvement that I guess that the incoming secretary could tweak or use, I guess, to focus on to improve come the next 6 years?
Well, for the challenges that the department encountered in the previous years, this will be presented to the team or to the transition team of Secretary Tulfo, and this will be discussed in the succeeding days. As mentioned earlier, we will begin with our cluster meetings and our briefing with our field offices and the supervised and attached agencies starting tomorrow. So from there, we could discuss the challenges, if there are any, that the different offices or field offices encountered in the previous years.
Okay. The SWD spokesperson, Ms. Irene Dumlao. Ms. Irene, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very much for having us.